Good evening, everyone. Starting off with a live look in downtown San Angelo. This is our sky tracker pointed off to the west. We had a little bit of thunderstorm activity, and you could just see a little bit of lightning on the left side of your television, or rather on the right side of your television screen. And we did have a little bit of thunderstorm activity earlier in the Concha Valley. It looks to have mostly dissipated right now. Looks like kind of the strongest thunderstorm activity right now, kind of in eastern portions of the Concha Valley, southeastern portions of McCulloch County, Brady down to Mason, over towards San Saba. And believe it or not, this little cluster of thunderstorms made it all the way from central Texas. Little bit of activity in the big country, getting into northern portions of Coleman County. This is the thunderstorm that produced gusty winds up in Taylor County, and the National Weather Service showed us a little bit of damage caused by those thunderstorms. It looks like things have mostly calmed down across west central Texas. When will our next rain chance be? It actually looks to be the middle of next week. We had this little weather maker. It's going to move toward the west, and with that looks to bring a pretty good rain chance towards west central Texas. The question is, what's the exact track of this low pressure system going to be? If it goes a little further to the south, that would decrease our rain chances, meaning less rainfall. And if it tracks further to the north, could bring some much welcomed rainfall to west central Texas. So certainly something to keep an eye on. This week, the main weather story for us was really just the heat. High temperature recorded on Monday in St. Angelo was 106, 108 for your Tuesday, 111 for your Wednesday. And that was a daily high temperature record for St. Angelo. 112 for your Thursday. That was the warmest temperature recorded for 2024 so far in San Angelo. Needless to say, it has been a warm week. 108, that was your high temperature today at St. Angelo Mathis Airport. 85 for your morning low temperature. Very warm start to the day that led us to a high temperature record of 108 for us in St. Angelo. Thankfully, less heat alerts across the area going into the weekend. Still have that heat advisory hanging on to the 90s in St. Angelo, 80s in the big country. 99, that's my forecasted high for your Saturday in St. Angelo. Warmest temperature on the 7 day. 97 for your Sunday, 95 for your Monday. Keeping an eye on some of those rain chances in the big country. Now, going to hand things off to our new meteorologist, Chris Nation in Abilene. Chris, we're excited to have you be a part of the team. What can folks expect in the big country?
Britton, appreciate that. You know, I'm excited to be part of the team. We're live up here in Abilene, and we're going to be doing this all the time now. And we want to make sure we really take care of our folks up here in Abilene. So you'll be down there. I'll be up here. We're going to double team coverage these folks to make sure they stay safe, they know what's happening, and make sure these weather impacts are covered. Now, we had isolated storms fire out by Waco out towards Dallas. Some of those went strong. Even up here, guys, we've had a few isolated poppers throughout the evening. Those will continue off and on. Well, they won't be huge rainmakers. We need every drop we can get. We take a quick check of the drought monitor. We're still having issues out there on the dry to moderate level, and we are still in that right here in Abilene. So they're gonna have to keep that in mind. We want to get every little bit of this moisture, but heat was an issue today. We had heat advisories, excessive heat warnings. I expect them to be back again tomorrow across the region, because even though we've had a mild cool front move through, it didn't do a whole lot. Didn't knock most of this moisture down, didn't really stabilize the environment that much. Now, if you can see, heat advisory spread across the area. We got to about 111 degrees out there today. That is just hot no matter where you're from. That is a ridiculously high temp, and we've been seeing this consecutively where temps just continue to climb out there, and then they get hotter and hotter out there. Got about 104 off towards Eastland. Our friends down towards Coleman got to about 107, all the way down to Comanche, 111 there as well. And our friends seeing way out by Snyder coming in about 105 there. It was an extremely toasty day out there. So we're going to see this pattern play out over the next few days, and that's going to be the main issue we have. In fact, as we take a quick check of the Futurecast computer, we see a few isolated tiny little spots. Not a lot of moisture in this thing, so I wouldn't be excited about it. We take a quick check tomorrow. We're looking at about 79, getting all the way to another 101 degrees out there, and then we see the next 7 days, much of the same, with a few isolated chances of storms off and on as we move towards the middle part of next week. Back to you.